Hey guys, how's it going? It's Flux here. Welcome back to City Skylines, Episode 3. And we're back in Fluxburgh. As you can see, I've let the city mature a little bit. I've kind of just let it all run itself out. As you can see, our education is slowly moving up now. We've got quite a bit educated and even some highly educated now and well-educated, so that's fantastic. You wouldn't believe how many elementary schools you actually need in these high-density areas, but it's actually quite a bit, as you can see. Our high school capacity is pretty good, but our elementary school capacity is just barely above. We may have to kick that up a little bit more. We only have two in this area right now, plus this one over here, but that'll come in later on. But for right now, we do have enough high educated and medium educated to start zoning the office space. So the cool thing about office zones, and something I kind of learned from just playing this game, is that these are immune to certain utilities. Now, I don't remember which ones exactly they are. I think it's I want to say it's healthcare and I forgot which ones it is now. You know what? Let's go ahead and zone some, and I'll show you what I mean in a minute here, though. But if you do zone office space all in the same area, you can actually avoid having any problems with having to. Well, obviously, for one thing, you don't need to put any education in that area, right? You don't need to have like any schools or anything in the office space area. So things like that, where if you have all of it kind of bunched together and then you have all the residential stuff and commercial stuff all together, you can avoid having to put certain utilities in that area, which is really nice. And also maximize the amount of residential you cover with each utility that you put down. So we'll start putting the office space somewhere over here, I think, instead. This is probably a good spot for the office space to be. I think maybe back here would be a good first zoning location, and kind of areas that are close to these power lines, so we can begin, I guess, making sure all these get powered properly. And now you can see we did have, I guess, some problems when we were putting down these grids. They aren't exactly perfect. I don't really know. I may also need to delete this. In fact, I will delete this elementary school over here. It's not really going to be necessary later on. But I haven't even put down any parks yet, which is cool, because we already have actually a pretty decent density. So that's cool. We can put some parks down later on, and you'll see this stuff really start to skyrocket and go into the much higher density buildings. But we'll throw down some office space and right away get some nice profit, which is fantastic. You can see, obviously, we're not going to need any sort of coverage for schools. That's a given. Let's see. I don't believe medical will actually require any either. It looks like it does not. So I was correct about that. Obviously, fire will need, we will need fire and police to cover these, though, which makes sense, of course. But that's nice. We don't have to worry about education or medical at all for the office buildings. So keep that in mind if you're zoning office. It's definitely kind of a plus of putting it all in big chunks like this. We do need some more commercial, though, and I want to put that alongside the main avenue over here. So I'll just throw all of this down like that. And probably actually delete this once we get that zoned in here. And I'll put it all the way across like this so we can just finish all this off real quick. Once this all grows in, then we'll be good to go. And as you can see, this new bridge over here is definitely helping out a lot with the traffic on both of these roads, which I like a lot. Definitely a nice little through traffic area over here. So you can see profit coming in here, which is great to see as well. And we're almost now to the point where we can delete this power line. That'll be nice. Let's see. Let me speed up a bit more here. Just get that done. Offices are coming in nicely as well, which is good. How about we work on some parks in the meantime? Let's slow this down a little bit so we don't get ahead of ourselves here. So for parks, I don't have a whole lot of custom parks installed. I have a few. Most of these are not actually parks, though. They're for things like parking lots. This is a 4x4 parking lot, I think. They don't have pictures for them or anything, but yeah, they're parking lots and stuff. Not really anything I actually need. Ooh, the Japanese garden, right. This was like an addition, I think, that was an accidental. Something happened where people weren't actually getting it, so they just gave it to everybody, which is kind of cool. It was supposed to be for the limited edition only people. I don't know exactly what happened there, but anyway, I kind of want to stick to one general park ground color. I think we'll probably use a lot of this one, or maybe this one. I know that these use the same types of pathways in them, which is what I want. So I might use these two kind of together quite a bit here. Now you'll see me make a lot of custom parks, but for things like this where I just want to have quick parks to basically just help out with our leisure, I'll use these instead. So maybe have one over here. We can actually connect all of our walkways and things to these parks, which is nice. So again, we'll use some kind of outer limit area to throw those down. And you'll see when we use, our pathways here, they're the exact same path types. Although this one doesn't actually let you connect to the actual park, but you can see it's the same type of path, so it'll look nice if you make a park all around it. I did use the same one twice. I kind of want to have at least one of these as well. In fact, I think I will throw one of these down here real quick. Although, actually, leisure over here is fantastic. And look at this. Already we're seeing some much higher density. It took us like 2 seconds of just throwing some leisure down to really fix that. Also, I think that was probably had something to do with these. And now, the interesting thing is you actually do need leisure for everything, including office buildings, which is kind of something you wouldn't really think. But that is true. People working in the office, all they do want parks to walk in for their lunch breaks. So I'm not going to use that big one over here. But I try and use the parks along the outside so I can kind of connect them with other things later on. So maybe have like one of these big parks over here by the highway. I don't want it to be blocking anything though. And that's too steep of a location. How about over here? This is a good spot for a park. Either way, we're going to want to connect something here. Maybe there. Actually, I think here's the best spot for it. Let's do that. So we can kind of branch it off into this little section back here. Maybe one more over here as well should do the trick. Like so. And now we've got happiness all throughout the land. And some nice new buildings popping up here. Fantastic. Now, I don't have any actual building growth mods quite yet, so you can actually get custom objects that will grow in your city whenever you zone new things. I don't have any of those yet. All I have are custom objects that you can place, which are these big buildings like this Pearl Roundabout or whatever. Does this actually line up with... Oh, it does. It lines up almost perfectly with the street at the end here, so we could make something like that. Kind of a nice little centerpiece. You know, it could be like the end of this or something. I don't know. I think this is also, no, this is already there, but where's some more? Here we go. This is custom. It's like a five-star hotel kind of thing. This thing is really big, this Skyarch building. What else do we have? Oh, yeah, I think I have a few other really tall buildings. The Vero Insurance. This one's pretty tall. This is a bank, I think. Yeah, it's a Russian or German bank. Russian, definitely Russian, right? I don't know. I think it's Russian. And then the Plaza Singapore. So these will probably come in later, and I'll put them in the more dense parts of our cities here when they kind of fit better and they look more natural. But it kind of helps improve the skyline a bit, because I've kind of noticed the one thing with this game, and it's kind of similar with SimCity, where you'll have most of the high-density buildings all grow high-density at the same time, and then it'll all just kind of be like one flat skyline. And if you want to make it look a little more, I don't know, like it's radiating outwards and it's kind of like a more unique looking skyline, you can throw in these custom buildings for some nice looks. So anyway, how's the leisure? The leisure is pretty much perfect, except for this side over here, obviously. These all grew in, so we can go ahead. Ooh, look at that. These are some nice looking office buildings. They're all the same, but they're nice looking, I guess. They're really densely packed too. That's the thing I like a lot about this game, is they really densely pack all the things. So, just the way the grid works and the zoning works looks nice. Like if you play SimCity, you know what I'm talking about, where they just kind of, it was really easy to like slightly mess up the grid enough that you would have giant gaps where you would not have any buildings, and it just didn't look good at all. You couldn't really even do things like this with the curves because it just wouldn't grow your city properly. But this game definitely fixes that a lot. It looks really nice. So anyway, more office buildings. Okay, we'll just get going with that then, if that's what they want. I think I'm going to try using some parks as well, though. I don't want to just zone a bunch if they're all low density. So I'm going to go ahead and zone. Oops, I put like one down there. I'll zone this whole thing, and then I'll start putting some parks down as well. And I think for the office areas, I almost want to use these big parks, which I don't even think fit properly in most locations. Yeah, maybe not that one then. Maybe we'll use this small park here. This one fits perfectly within these little areas, so it's kind of a good one to use. So maybe like one there, and then like one more. Oh, actually, we'll just do a double. That's kind of cool. Double park right there. Nice green space like around the office area. That's cool, actually. I like that. I like that little plaza in the middle there. That'll kind of give us nice leisure all around the office buildings over here. And we're almost to a point where we can, if we just get one more row of offices over here, we could actually just completely get rid of this power line section over here. So let's see if we can make that happen now. Just to get it over with. Now I am seeing more demand for commercial. We actually deleted this unnecessarily. We had a road over here earlier that I got rid of. I think I was trying to make this thing work. We didn't actually need to do that. But as you can see, our sorting method is actually working really well because it's just a narrow enough of a difference that if you're going to this part of town, you would go right, and if you're going to this part of town, you would go left, and it definitely sorts the traffic really nicely, so you don't get too much on the road, which is really nice. These parks are looking nice. That's cool. Okay, so let's get this last little part down here, which we had earlier and I deleted on accident. This can go, let's see, we got to here, right? Oh, one more. When you have avenues, you have to take into account the one extra grid space that they take up. So instead of going to here, we go one more out, like so, and there we go. And I might actually do that twice. Yeah, we will. So we'll do something like that. That'll look nice. Nice and optimized. And I think I'm actually going to use... well, we have these barriers here, so there's not any noise pollution. So we don't actually need the treeside roads. And I kind of like these better for the more dense city sides because they've got more shoulder space than the tree roads. And that's nice when you're trying to park cars along the side. I wouldn't want big shoulders. So anyway, look at some more commercial down. Ooh, that's not commercial. There we go. And I like to put this along, like I've said before, I like to put it along the kind of main avenues. That's kind of what you would see anyway in the real world. And then some high density residential. We still got demand. We got demand for more office buildings. So these, I guess they aren't really growing. I think we're missing some services, though. We've got police. We've got kind of got fire. Fire's fine. We don't need medical. So what are we missing then? Leisure's fine, right? Yeah, leisure's pretty much fine. Is it just profit, or are they already at their max size? Oh, they're getting there. One overeducated worker. Okay. They're doing fine. We just need more of them. That's all. So I'll zone some more kind of along this area as well. But so far, so good with the traffic, especially, which is nice. All right. Let's do some more. Oh, man. We really just need offices more than anything. So this grew out. We can go ahead and delete these little power lines here. Get rid of those. Maybe use some more offices along here as well then, while we're at it. Because we only have offices for work, we really do need a lot of them, more than usual anyway. Education's pretty high in this area. And I do want to do some kind of farmland stuff, like way out away from this main city. But I think for the main city, it's nice to just have pretty much everybody be high education and working educated jobs. As you can see, that's growing nicely over here as well. Fantastic. I don't want to zone on this road. That's a mistake you can make that really sucks, is if you have zoning on this exit road, then you can go and you can get to the shop, but then to get back to the city again, you have to go all the way around and re-exit the city, which is a total pain. You have to literally go on onto the highway, all the way down into the interchange, and pull the entire roundabout and get back over onto the highway again and come back just to get in the city again. So you definitely don't want to zone on these roads. It's a pretty easy mistake to make. Wow, the commercial demand is still there. Just keep on zoning. Maybe some chunks along the park will be... This is probably a good place to zone as well. Yeah, like alongside where the park's going to be. This will be a big park over here in the middle. So maybe some there and some over here. Ooh, we have some demand for power. Did we not get power over here? Oh, that could be a problem. Hold on, we should zone this real quick. Let's see. I think commercial along here is a good spot as well. Use the paintbrush to do this. Pretty much all the way up through here and all the way down to about there. And that should let us connect to this area over here. I think so anyway. We'll see. Did they get their power? They might have already gotten their power actually. Oh yeah, they're connected. Wow. Must have been by that little building right there. Just did the trick right there. Fantastic. Alright, good. Upgrades are happening. We're getting close to the max size now, which is fantastic. And I love how dense these are. This is really nice. Look at this, they're like right up against each other, which is really good looking. Once we get this side zoned as well, it'll be really tight. These are coming along nicely as well. We're almost at the fifth level. I think this is the... Oh, it's not there yet, actually. They're all about there. I think they're happy. What do they want, though, do we think? Probably public transportation would be the next step to make all this better. And we'll get there. We'll get there. I want to make a big bus depot somewhere over here, which will come kind of later on in the series. But for now, let's just continue zoning all this stuff. And really, we just basically want to make sure we just keep this balanced and just keep on throwing down zones. And next thing we know, we will have this whole thing filled out. And I almost want to do some office space over here as well. It's probably a good spot for that. So I don't have to go too far to get to their office space. Actually, you know what? No, let's not do that. Let's keep doing what we're doing here and just continue putting office buildings all together so we can avoid putting any education down. I'm pretty sure that education doesn't... Yeah, we don't need it for the commercial either. So keeping residential all in one location is definitely beneficial. Do we need medical for these? Oh, we don't. Wow, so you only need a medical for residential. Medical and education. Which makes sense, I guess. You wouldn't really care if your business is next to a school or not. Unless the land value increases, I guess. That's about it. Try and zone all of this stuff. And we'll do some more over here as well. So this is a high school that's actually disconnected right now that we'll reconnect whenever we get. In fact, I might delete this for now until we get more residential over here. Because right now it's not even any residential in this area. Let me start zoning some more residential over here though. Alright, so far so good though. We may need some more leisure here in a minute. We'll see about that. Throw some more high density down over here. Obviously, this will be probably our main source of leisure for this side. Yeah, we can see already some demand for that on this side. This is probably a good spot for that, right? Or actually, you know what? We should make it kind of... Okay, I've got an idea now. So let me find something that's going to cross over nicely. I think this would be the answer to that. I want this to move into this park over here. Or actually, how far, I guess, does this even move? That's the real thing, because if we can get... Hang on. I want to plan this out properly. I don't want to just start throwing random parks in here if we don't have an actual cool park planned out. The tricky part is incorporating these pre-made ones that actually influence this with the path that doesn't influence this. So we do need to use the in-game parks as well, which is kind of difficult to work with. I think our first step will be throwing in some parking lots for this big park. So maybe a few over here. And that actually does increase leisure, believe it or not. Oh, so we could probably just use parking lots, and that would be all we really need over here. So we'll do, yeah, we'll do a few parking lots on this side and on this side. Maybe like there, there, and there. And then do another set here, here, and here. It's like it's not a huge amount of leisure. Oh, actually it is, wow. Those are nice looking. I like these parking lots. Little nice looking trees and everything in there. And then we can use our pathways. And this is all mods, by the way. These I downloaded these on the Steam Workshop. You can just go into the Steam Workshop. And I look at the most subscribed list. That's kind of the easiest way to find really cool looking mods and things for this game. But you can really look anywhere you want. Try and find good mods. And the nice thing about this is we all have schools literally built on the park. So you could if you go to the school, you could just walk right outside and have a giant park right next to your school. Which I kind of like that. It's cool. We'll connect these along here. Space already occupied. Okay. That's fine. And then maybe do some more parking over here. I actually think this is probably okay, though. How is the leisure? That's the real question. Looks pretty good, actually. Yeah, that's good then. We don't need anything else over here besides maybe some actual park walkways. I'll throw some more walkways back here as well. And I think I'll use the concrete. I want to use the concrete for most of the urban areas, and then we'll use the dirt paths for some of this less urban stuff. So I think the first step is making some sort of centerpiece here. Maybe do it. Have like a. Let's see. I want these to connect. Like this. And maybe over here. There we go. Have this come this way. Back around again. Hang on, that's not right. Like there. There we go. That's good. Kind of like an outer connection there. We have one of these go in this way. Same thing over here. But from over here, maybe. Like here. Okay, so far so good. That's kind of a weird connection there. That's alright though. Now for the center of the park. This is the tricky part. I kind of like having a little circle or something. The hard part is we can't use any monuments or anything. Because I like this center roundabout fountain. But it needs to be on roads. Which is why it's so tricky to do. Maybe if we did like dirt roads. That would kind of look bad, though. Like if we did something like... I don't think this is going to work, but let me just try. I'm curious. Yeah, something like this, and then we built the dirt roads all around it. Like that. That's kind of cool, actually. And then we do this. Or actually, why don't we use dirt stuff on the inside just for the sake of, I don't know, better looking pathways? That would look nice, right? Like that. Yeah, that's cool. And we'll just kind of do that. That's too close to the edge, isn't it? There we go. Even branch these off over here. That's pretty cool. I like this. I honestly didn't think I was going to like the fact that we had these dirt roads in here, but I kind of like it. Hang on, this is going to be hard to do. Yeah, that kind of does that little glitch there, but that's okay. I think it looks fine. And then we'll connect these areas over here, the same way we just did that. So, like that, and then maybe something over here. Let's try and make it go back this way again, like that. And then... cool, that's cool. Looks like a centerpiece. I like that. One more over here. Let's try from here. That did the same glitch. That's okay though. Cool. I like it. Very nice little park there. We could name it something later on. If you guys have a suggestion, actually, you could leave it in the comments for a cool name for this park. You could name the whole thing. Make its own little district or something. That'd be nice. Anyway, let's go ahead and put some trees down then. Make it look really nice. So do some nice bushes right along here. There we go. Oh. Trying to get this little spot here. Sometimes you like place them and they don't actually appear. It's kind of weird. I gotta say though, I like this aspect of this game a lot. I like that they kind of have these like free placement objects, like a lot of these. That was the thing with SimCity that kind of sucked, is it didn't really feel like you could really make a section feel like unique and personal. You could zone things and you could draw some pathways and stuff, but you had to use like the college pathways and there really wasn't a lot you could do to make it feel unique and like custom made. So I really like that City Skylines lets you do that. I want to get something in over here. It just looks like a kind of smaller. Yeah, that's better. Alright, cool. Maybe do that along the outside as well. Oops. There we go, and then all on the outside over here. Sorry for the large amount of clicking going on. There we go. I like this park though, it's looking nice. And I like the centerpiece too, that's cool. To try that more often, using these dirt roads for centerpieces. I can't see what I'm doing over here because of this tree. I like to see more custom tree or bush objects. I know that could be a possibility from the modding community. Requires some knowledge of asset creation, though, a little further beyond just making buildings. I actually would be willing to bet there's probably already stuff out there for that in the mod section of the workshop. I may take a look after this episode and see what I can find. I'm sure there's some new stuff already out there. Awesome, that's cool. And I almost want to just... here, let's start by deleting all of these trees just that are like scattered in random places. clear off this area. I want to see if I can basically just... I want to really control the landscaping in this area, make it look like it's all clean and on purpose. So let's see if we can do that, or at least get that illusion going. And we could always zone on these areas here, but I almost feel like I don't want to do that. Let's see if I can get some trees in here. They look kind of nice. Got some nice trees here and there. I also like how easy it is to place things like trees in little areas between spaces. That's kind of cool too, like that, what I just did there. Anyway, so for the landscaping with this park, I think I want to do like a full dense forest on these outer areas over here to kind of separate it from the rest of the city. This will be the little bit of buffer space for whatever noise pollution would exist if you were doing this in real life. And I like to use primarily these trees because they have variation in color. And then we'll go back and throw some other trees in there later on as well. Here comes all the clicking. Alright, good so far. I know there's brushes available as well. I may actually need to look into that. Like big tree brushes. Those work out pretty well for things like this. We got some more demand for office buildings now, but you can see we've already got our profit margins going up. They were at like negative 30,000, now they're only at like negative 12,000. So slowly but surely we're building back up again until we'll be in the positive again. So that's good to hear. Go ahead and throw all this stuff down real quick. Almost done. I've also kind of noticed that this game seems to be more played on Twitch than on YouTube. And I can kind of see that. I did it a bit on Twitch before I started playing on YouTube. And I don't know, it's just, it's one of those games where you spend a lot of time doing things like this that are kind of tedious and, I don't know. Be a little less interesting to watch on like a YouTube video, but more fun to watch on Twitch when you're just messing around and talking to the chat. So that's kind of something about this game that makes it a little more Twitch friendly. But I do like how this game just really did take off, like more even than most of these games in this genre do. Like SimCity was so hyped up, and even that game didn't get anywhere near what this game's getting in terms of attention. Like, it gets upvoted on Reddit to like the front page regularly, and you know, it's on the front page of Twitch pretty regularly. Not like the front page, but the top games list anyway. So things like that that give this game a bit of a boost, which is nice to see. Lots of wind over here. I wonder if this wind is dynamic. I wonder if the amount of sway in the trees is actually reflecting on how much wind is in this area, because if that's true, then that's super cool. Hang on, I'm gonna check in a minute and see if that's actually the case. Maybe it's just like they're always swaying that much and I just never noticed. Hang on, let me look and see. Where's the wind map here? Here we go. Oh yeah, it is pretty windy over here. It's not like the max wind. Anyway. Alright, looking good. I want to add some trees from the last tree I want to add to this one. This one's really bright. Kind of add some variation of the tree types. You can throw this one in there. The maps actually have different trees too, which is kind of cool. If you haven't played this game yet, you might not know. But certain maps have different trees in them, which is kind of weird. Like this one doesn't have the big tall tree that I think is in the forest maps more. This one's kind of a forest map. I don't know. There's also no pine trees in this one. Or not pine trees. Well, yeah, no pine trees. But there's also no palm trees, I meant to say. Alright, so anyway. We finish up the park just about. We need to add some stuff to the main part of the park. Ooh, we've got some criminal activity going on at our... Wow, really? You know, I didn't even realize that was the criminal right there. That's the dude. That's the guy. Hey. Get back here. Wow, crime rate is high. How are we even going to deal with this, actually? I didn't really think about this, but, like, how can crime possibly be dealt with on something like this? I mean, I guess it can't. I mean, it is on streets, so that kind of sucks. We can't have any police cars getting there. It's basically just not really something we can have dealt with. Unless we had, like, a dirt trail that went off this way or something. Or this way. I may have to do that. Like, make a dirt trail that goes off and then connects to the main road again. In fact, I think I will do that. Maybe over here or something. Yeah, we could do that. We could just delete this little path here. And these two. Make the dirt road just kind of come off this way. It's gonna collide with this. We'll have to redraw this again as well. Hang on a minute. Let's see. Yeah, like that. That's kind of odd. That's okay. And then, let's see, where is our walkway again? Connect these two. Can I not connect these? So you can just get close like that. We're too close there. Alright, that's fine. We'll make some trees over here. That'll just allow the police cars to get over here and bust all our criminals that are apparently messing around here. I don't know why that's the case. I'll just quickly put back these trees again. Alright, so anyway, that's today's episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. I think I'm going to go ahead and just do some RCI balancing real quick and let the city mature a bit more so we can get some more money coming in and hopefully get close to the positives again. And then next episode, we can go ahead and start zoning the rest of this stuff and probably some more RCI balancing, of course. We may need to start upping our... Looks like our hospital's fine, but things like education, I think, are going to start getting close to being... not even really that too bad, but probably when we start using this area. So we'll see about all that stuff, and then hopefully even do a bus depot. That may be next episode. We'll see how far we get into the rest of the city first. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed, and as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.